Welcome back to Great Day. Oral head and neck cancers claim nearly 13,000 lives each year. Catching it early is many times the difference between life and death. Here to tell us about symptoms to look out for and where you can get screened for free is ENT specialist Dr. Ron J. Karni with UT Physicians. Good morning. All right. There are several different ways how somebody can end up with this type of cancer, but the bottom line is it can happen to anyone, sometimes with unexplained reasons. Or tobacco can exacerbate some things, though, right?
Yes, of course. Well, the historic risk factor here was tobacco. Whether you're chewing tobacco or cigarettes, we've known for a long time that people who do that have a higher risk for head and neck cancers.
All right. We mentioned some symptoms a little bit earlier, but by the time people show symptoms, if at all, oftentimes does that indicate that that cancer is somewhat advanced?
It can. In some instances, that's true. The message here is not to ignore the symptoms. Sometimes it's a lump in the neck that has no pain, and so people ignore it.
Yeah.
And that's a mistake. Our message is if you have a lump in the neck, even if it has no pain, see a doctor, get that checked out.
Yeah, at least get it checked. Because sometimes people think, okay, I have some congestion or my lymph nodes are swollen, that happened before, but you gotta get it checked out so you can eliminate whether that's the issue or not. Okay, what does the examination look like? And you can actually kind of do that right here, right?
Yes, exactly. Okay. So we, as part of a head and neck cancer program and part of UT Physicians, we host a free screening and we do this every year. It's been almost 10 years now that we do this. We throw our doors open between 2 and 4 o'clock on April 11th.
Okay.
And what is the free screening? That's a few questions I'll ask you and we'll do that right now.
Okay.
Deborah,
right.
And then I'll examine you as well.
All right.
So, Deborah, do you feel like you have a lump in the neck?
I don't feel like I do.
Have you had any change in your voice or swallowing?
No, I swallow wine just fine.
Very good. And any pain in the head and neck?
Sometimes I get a crick in my neck, but not. I think okay. It's kind of how I slept.
So the trick here is persistent pain. If we
yeah.
have something that's constant and not going away.
Yeah.
But even that crick in the neck, you should have checked
and
out.
And there are some people who are pain in the neck, but that's probably not what you're talking about.
No, that I can't fix for
yeah.
you.
Okay, all right.
So let me take a look.
Okay.
So I'll ask you to say a big ah for me here.
That's
perfect. You are very good at this. That all looks very good.
Okay.
And I'm gonna take a feel of your neck here for a moment.
Okay. Now, one thing I do have is I have hypothyroidism, and so a lot of people will ask, does that mean I'm more prone to any type of cancer like this?
No, hypothyroidism is a different condition where your thyroid doesn't function adequately,
yeah.
But I wouldn't consider it a risk factor for yeah. head and neck cancer.
Okay, so am I gonna live?
Everything's perfect.
Yeah. All right. What does treatment look like, though? And again, getting in early is the key.
Yes. So the key here is if you do get early detection and you have a head and neck cancer, the treatments can be much more minimally invasive. A good example of that is, for instance, robotic surgery, something that we can do in 2 hours and cure a cancer as opposed to having to go through a much longer treatment with more side effects.
Yeah. All right. So we've talked about who should go in and get tested if you have some type of symptom, but is there any other group who should just come in just to keep maintenance?
So I think everybody should be talking about cancers in general with their primary doctor. Mm-hmm. It's important to talk about prevention and also screening. So, you know, if you're over the age of 50, there's all kinds of things you need to do, like colonoscopies and so forth.
Yeah.
But the population we're targeting are those that have a symptom in the head and neck that I've described that haven't spoken to their doctor about it. It's just not something to ignore. Oftentimes, the patient will tell us, you know, I sat on this for 4 months because it didn't bother me.
Yeah.
And those are the patients we want to raise awareness
about.
And we
just get busy, but that getting busy can cost you your life. Okay, ENT, so ear, nose, throat specialist. Are you the same person if we went to you for allergies or something like that?
Correct.
Okay, so yeah. Sometimes you can go in and just say, are you checking for other things sometimes when we go in for one specific thing?
Yeah, when you see an ear, nose, and throat doctor, you can see them for a myriad of different things.
Yeah.
Cancer is just one area
yeah.
of that.
Yeah.
So it could be, you know, kids with tonsillitis or allergies this time of year with pollen and things like that. But today's message is really about the head and neck
yeah.
cancers.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, thank you very much. UT Physicians is having that free screening for oral head and neck cancer on April 11th from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. For a list of locations, just visit utphysicians.com or you can call this number right here. It's 888-4-UT-DOCS, 888-4-UT-DOCS.